The Antec 1000 HCG Extreme. Well, 1000 watts does sound a lot, but it feels puny when compared to Goku's power level of...
It's over 9000!
Hey everyone, Mukul here. Now, just because I make YouTube videos whatever close to tech things I do in life, it always makes me wonder if that specific activity could be good content too. Now, because there was no proper guide regarding how to install the Antec HCG 1000 watt power supply, I thought why not just make one. As most of the modular power supplies get installed similarly, you can use this guide for a lot of different PSUs installation for your PC. So yeah, this odd colored themed looking PSU might not like by everyone, but I care the least as it is going to anyway hide behind the PSU shroud. And I bought it because of its power efficiency rating, the 10 year of warranty, and because I got a really good deal on it in the times of Corona inflated pricing everywhere, as compared to the other 850 watts which I was considering. This PSU specifically comes with a hybrid mode button, which when enabled allows the fan to switch off completely under low load situations. Being a 1000 watt PSU, there are many sockets for a lot of components and peripherals which the power supply can easily support laughingly. Well, to be honest, until you throw 3 3090s on it, but let's be real, no one is that rich. In the package, you get 6 PCI cables, out of which 2 are dual daisy chained 8-pin PCIe connectors, and the rest 4 are dedicated 8-pin PCI connectors. These cables are mostly used to power your GPUs, but strangely, the dual daisy chained 8-pin connector cable was thinner than the single 8-pin connector PCIe cable. So that could mean the thicker single 8-pin connector cable can carry more wattage on it. Or maybe there's some other reason. I am not an electrician with a voltmeter, so I can't do any volta analysis over this. And then there are 2 CPU 8-pin connector cables to power on, well, you guessed it right, your CPU. And because you installed your CPU on the motherboard, these wires will go inside the motherboard and not on the CPU. I think that was kind of obvious. But then that's not the only cable that goes inside the motherboard. The 20 plus 4-pin 12 volts ATX connector cable goes into the main 24 or 20-pin socket on your motherboard. In case your motherboard just needs 20-pin connector, you can plug only that part and leave the rest of the 4 pins just hanging there lonely without a soulmate ever in their life. Then there are 3 cables with multiple SATA ports to power on your hard drives, etc. And 1 Molex cable with 4 Molex connectors and some SATA ports if you are still using a few non-SATA powered hard drives. Or if, for example, some fans of your case which might need the Molex connector to power on. And the most important floppy disk drive connector to decrypt those old Area 51 files, which will reveal more about aliens to the humanity when the time is right. Then of course there is a 16 ampere power plug with a fuse inside of it, which would need an adapter for India's power sockets. I still don't understand it, but it's just the weirdest thing that the PSUs here still don't come with pins compatible with our wall sockets. I mean, they could have fixed this if they just put a little more extra efforts over this, but mostly they have been like meh. So yeah, buy an adapter. And in the box there was some Antec bands and zip ties for cable management, which is still mostly alien to me, but I always try my best. And I think I always fail. So before installing the PSU inside the case, you gotta make sure you understand what are the existing components in your system to which you're going to give power to, like how He-Man did to Castle Grayskull, I guess. In your PC, of course, you would have a motherboard because no one likes father's terminology in tech realm. Apart from it, you might also have a graphic card, which in my case was the RTX 3080 FE, which needs 2 8-pin PCIe power connectors. You might also have a few hard drives, like I have one of them, but as it's a SATA drive, I don't need the Molex connector cable. But because this PSU also comes with a cable that has a mix of SATA and Molex connectors on it, I decided to go with it, as at this stage I recall the ARGB fans in my case might need a Molex connector to power on. Now these pins on the connectors and the sockets on the PSU are keyed. And by keyed I mean they have differently shaped plastic housing over them. Well, they are mainly a square and an AGD. This is so that the installation stays idiot proof. Yeah. So if a connector doesn't go inside a port, well, don't push it hard thinking it's challenging your manliness or womanliness, whichever that case may be, as that could mean there's a possibility you're not plugging them correctly. So before pushing them in, it's a good habit to cross-check the connectors with the PSU and the other components ports. Also, it's better to pre-plan in which orientation you are going to put your PSU in and plug these cables, keeping that in mind so that they don't stretch much in case any of these cables is shorter in length. So because I am going to put my PSU fan facing down, I will put the cables in this orientation only. So at first I will install these cables to the PSU before putting the PSU in the case. As because of the shroud, it won't be easy to push my hand down the very narrow area later to plug these connectors in. Also, this is kind of sort of common sense, so yeah. So I began with the 24-pin connector first because, well, it seemed easier. The PSU clearly says M/P, which means motherboard. So this first step was as easy as a Lego game with a manual, of course. Make sure you put the correct side of the connectors inside the PSU sockets. Also, the clips on the top of these connectors, well, they will just clip so that you can start clipping the next one. And to make things even easier, the cables have sticker at one end to specify which side will go inside the PSU. So the next cable I decided to put was the CPU ATX 12 volts one. Now you would see that basically all the ports say PCIe/CPU on them, so I can use any of these ports as long as the total 8 pins go inside correctly in either one of them. I could have used these two separate PCIe/CPU pins too, but I thought to reserve them for my GPU. There is absolutely no technical reasoning behind this, as I mostly went with the flow. Now at first for the GPU, I used the daisy chained 2 8-pin cable, but later replaced it with a single dedicated 8-pin cable and installed two of them to power the GPU in my system. The RTX 3080 Ti uses a peak power of 320 watts and I don't plan to overclock it at all. But just because these extra PCIe slots and cables have no other purpose and they will be lying around waste, it just felt better to me to give the GPU power without daisy chaining and use these two dedicated PCIe cables instead. I would recommend you the same if your PSU allows, but don't stress too much as long as you're not overclocking the graphic card. And if you definitely are going to overclock, then yeah, definitely put them. And also there are many graphic cards these days which might need 3 8-pin power connectors to power on. So in that case, you would need to use one of these daisy chained 8-pin power connectors with a dedicated or another daisy chained power connector if you want. Now these 5-pin connectors are for the cable which will power my hard drives, I mean my system's hard drives. And as mentioned earlier, they are a mix of Molex and SATA power connectors. Now after installing all the cables, I will carefully put the PSU in the same orientation in the PSU slot. And I'm again iterating, the fan will face down so that it can suck the air from the bottom of the case and throw that hot air out from behind. But if your case doesn't have vents on the bottom for some reason, or if it doesn't have feet for air circulation, or if you are putting it in a mushy thick carpet, then you should definitely make the intake fan of the PSU face upward. Because really, in all these scenarios, it will be tough for the PSU to suck any air in the first place. And then make sure you screw your PSU because no one likes things dangling around their PC. And then let's start connecting stuff to these hungry cable connectors. As already mentioned, I had put the daisy chained cable to the GPU first and later replaced them with 2 8-pin cables. After connecting these PCIe cables to the GPU, pull the extra mount back in the PSU shroud as no one likes looking at these ugly stock cables in the PCMR community. After connecting the GPU, my hands move to connect the 24-pin ATX power connector. This might need moderate Hulk power at times, but just don't put too much force into it. And be sure the connection is keyed right before pushing these connectors in. Some motherboards support 8+4 pins for the eATX connectors to supply more power to the CPU in case if it is being extremely overclocked. But if your motherboard doesn't have the extra 4 pins for the eATX connector, then do not worry at all. That means your motherboard can't support extreme overclocking anyways. So yeah, clearly everything worked out in the end. Also, many of the lower wattage power supplies do not have the extra 4 pins for the eATX connector, which implies that they cannot support the extra overclocking you expect the poor power supply to do anyway. Now, because my CPU cooler and stuff were already installed and I was too lazy to take out everything, I tried to connect the other eATX pins without uninstalling anything from the system. And because of the extremely narrow space and my huge freaking hand, I kind of sort of wounded my knuckles a bit. So once I saw some bruises over my knuckles, the bulb on top of my head lit and I figured I could just put a cloth over the heatsink of the cooler to protect it from further damage. I also took out the top exhaust fan because getting wounded injected some sanity in me, I guess. So after connecting these 8+4 pins, the toughest part of the whole installation process was almost over. And after this, I simply connected the SATA power connector to the single 3.5-inch hard drive which is there in my system. And the Molex connector was used to power the ARGB fans connector, which are there in the front of my case. So everything just worked out fine in the end. Well, except for my bruised hand, which is now fine, by the way. And I swear this time, I honestly attempted to do some sort of cable management on the right side of the case, which you can also rate, but no, wait, I was just kidding. Don't. So yeah, after all of this, you can finally close the case back and put the main power cord to the CPU and connect it to your wall socket or UPS. So I will post some of the links of the components used in the video in the description below. You can buy stuff from there if you want to support my efforts on this video or for all the other videos I make on the channel. Also, you can come visit us on our Discord server for more chit chats on relevant topics. So stay safe, humans. That's all for today. MewBot out.